you didn't.
You win this round, Lois.
You're not being creative. You're just destroying a wonderful show.
Hey, I have more creativity in my whole party than most people do before 9 a.m.
The only thing you create before 9 a.m. is exactly what you've turned my show into.
I think my work will speak for itself. Oh, ha ha, I just got that. A poop joke? That's real creative, Lois. Okay, let's run this scene again. I remember, Diane, you're playing Anna, a steel town girl on a Saturday night looking for the fight of her life.
Now, where does it say that?
In my noodle. Okay, places, and action. All wrong. God, send me dances.
We've been rehearsing for hours. I'm exhausted.
Well, I'm sorry, but we opened the show in 3 hours, and I don't think we're ready.
Of course we're not. You keep changing everything.
You bet I do, because theater is alive. It's a living, breathing creature with wants and needs, and you're not man enough to satisfy her.
I can't work this way. I quit.
Fine. We can't do The King and I without Anna.
Yeah, this is a real snafu.
We don't need Diane Simmons. We've had someone better all along. Someone radiant and sassy, with a soul and a passion that can only come from hundreds of years of black oppression.
Oh, thank you, Peter. I'll do it.
Now get over yourself. I was talking about me.
Studio.
2 minutes, y'all, everybody. 2 minutes.
Jeez, full house. Well, look who came crawling back. Here.
I don't get it, Mom. If you're so mad at Dad for wrecking your show, why did you come to opening night?
I came because I love the theater. I mean, if I just came here to enjoy watching your father be humiliated when this asinine spectacle of his is ridiculed by everyone in town, what kind of person would I be?
A bitch.
Cheyenne, 2015 AD. The city lies in ruins after the ninth nuclear...